Welcome you all in a new lecture series of noise in analog modulation. Here we discuss basically the noise performance in different analog modulation techniques. So first we are required to know what is noise. Noise is any type of unknown signal which distorts the transmitted signal, which affects in the recovery or demodulation process of desired signal. During transmission, there is an introduction of noise, which is additive in nature and hence called additive distortion. In the communication system, transmitter and receivers are basically consist of electronic devices and are the major source of additive noise. Also, there might be any other electromagnetic signal which can interfere with the desired EM signal, which make received signal noisy. Generally, the received signal in analog modulation is a function of time and is a combination of transmitted signal S function T and W function T, which is called front end receiver noise. Here, the noise is called additive white Gaussian noise. So, received signal is denoted by R function T equals to ST plus WT. Now, in order to find quality or performance in analog communication, the first step is to determine the signal-to-noise ratio, or simply written as SNR. Here, SNR is the ratio of signal power to noise power. So, to understand briefly, we consider a typical analog communication system, which consists of input message source, M function T, transmitter, channel, also channel noise, which is additive in nature, and after this the received signal is collected by a receiver, where we basically find SNR at the input side and SNR at the output side. So the signal to noise ratio plays an important role in determining the noise performance, and it should be improved by increasing the signal power or transmitted power S suffix T. But the maximum increase in transmitted power is limited by many factors, such as this will increase the cost of communication system, maximum signal power required, increase channel capacity, and also affected by the interference problem. So, to understand the noise performance, we consider a receiver model as shown in figure. Here the input received signal is equals to modulated signal S function T and front end receiver noise W function T. Receiver model basically consists of a bandpass filter and a demodulator. The purpose of bandpass filter is to convert front end receiver noise WT into a band limited filter noise and function T and having a same bandwidth as transmission bandwidth. And the input received signal becomes XT equals to ST plus NT. Here N function T is called filtered noise, and it is a band limited and compatible with the transmitted signal S function T. Now, at the input of the demodulator, input signal and noise is denoted by SI and NI respectively. And after demodulation, we have output signal S0 and noise N0. Now here, we note a point. Spectral density of WT is denoted by capital S function F, and it is equals to N0 by 2. Where N0 is called the average noise power per unit bandwidth. Since the noise is random in nature, and to compute its power, it must measure over a specific bandwidth. That's why bandpass filter is required to convert front end receiver noise WT into a filtered noise power NT. Here, the ideal characteristic of bandpass filter noise is shown in figure. It has a power spectral density of N0 by 2, where N0 is called average noise power per unit bandwidth, which means in one bandwidth, average noise power is N0, and for transmission bandwidth B suffix T, its value is N0 into BT. So the filter noise power at the output is N0 into B suffix T. While in practical case, generally carrier frequency is far greater than transmission bandwidth. So, the filter noise is called narrowband noise and written mathematically in terms of in-phase component and quadrature component known as canonical form. So, filtered noise or narrowband noise is equals to Ni function t cos 2pi fct minus Nq function t sin 2pi fct, where N suffix I is called in-phase component and N suffix Q is called quadrature component. And for demodulation process, filtered signals becomes X function t equals to st plus nt. And with the help of this equation, we can define signal power to noise power ratio in terms of expectation operator. So, SNR equals to expectation of S square T upon expectation of N square T, where capital E is called expectation operator and a square of the signal level is directly proportional to power. So this ratio represents ratio of average signal power to average noise power, which is measured at a receiver side at a specific point. It may be at input or at output, which having its own importance and significance value. So at the input side of the demodulator, that is called front end receiver, we can find input SNR denoted by SNR suffix I. It is also called pre-detection SNR. This pre-detection SNR measures the quality of transmission link and front end of the receiver. Similarly, at the output of the receiver, we find SNR naught called as post-detection SNR, and this output SNR ratio measures the quality of the information bearing signal, which may in the form of audio, video signal, etc. Now, after discussing a receiver model and SNR at the input and output side, we are ready to compare noise performance between different analog modulation, demodulation techniques. Now first, we consider a reference model that is applicable for different transmission schemes. This is a basic transmission model, which includes a low-pass filter having bandwidth equal to the message bandwidth, so that it can pass the message signal and reject the out-of-band noise. Here, at the input side, message or modulated signal power get added by a channel noise denoted by W function T and then passes through low-pass filter. And at the output, we get filtered signal that corresponding to the information-bearing signal. In this reference transmission model, signal-to-noise ratio is equal to ratio of average power of modulated message signal upon average power of noise that is measured in message bandwidth. So this reference signal to noise ratio is measured at receiver input and also called as channel signal to noise ratio. Now with the help of reference SNR and output SNR, we can find figure of merit. Figure of merit is equals to the ratio of output SNR upon reference SNR. And for the betterment of noise performance of the receiver, this figure of merit should have high value. It may be equal to 1, greater than 1, and less than 1, which totally depend upon the type of different modulation scheme. So here we have discussed three types of signal to noise ratio. First is input signal to noise ratio, that is measured before the signal is demodulated. Output signal to noise ratio is measured after the signal is demodulated. And reference signal to noise ratio is based on a baseband transmission scheme. So here, with the help of input signal to noise ratio and output or reference signal to noise ratio, we can determine figure of merit, which is used for analysis of noise performance of receiver. Also, as the figure of merit is the ratio of 2 SNR, that's why it is a dimensionless quantity.